While I have the engine out, I decided that it was time to replace these CV boots. I have the replacement kit, and these are just, you know, they're old. This one you can see here, a little bit damaged. But if you look over here, this is the particularly bad one. So, pop the Allen head bolts off, remove it, replace the boots, put it all back together, and one step closer. So, all right, I'm gonna get started. I'm hammering them in to make sure that it's fully seated so I don't strip it out. Some of these are in there pretty tight, which I guess you want your axle bolts to be, but I have a couple on this side that are just completely boogered up and stripped out, and I'm probably gonna have to cut the heads off with my grinder and a cutoff wheel, pull the axle, remove the stud with vice grips, and then replace the bolts. Okay. That one stripped out. All right. How it comes off. There's one end of the CV joint. There's the other. I think I'll have to give that a bit of a clean. But one axle out. Now I just gotta get to the other one.
I recorded with Jimi Hendrix and Janis Joplin. Out there at the Fillmore West. Blues at Sunrise. You remember how we used to settle down when we get tired of jumping up and down, you know, in the club? Back up and reach and get one from the bottom.
Gotta take those off, and that one. So looks like I'll need 4 new bolts. But at least I can rebuild the axles, and I can reinstall them, and just leave one bolt off of each of these four ends, and then put them back in when I get the bolts. So right in here, there is a snap ring. Flip it in there with pliers. Okay, so this is the replacement boot. And so what I need to do is this edge here, right in here, you see it? I gotta break that clear from the joint itself. There it goes. Okay, so obviously this has been on there for a while, so I am going to have to beat it off a little bit. It's on there pretty snug, so I'm just using my puller here. There we go. Washer. So I got the boots off of both of those. Now I just got to get it off of here. This is one of those pinch clamps. Clean axle. Alright. And see my woman's over there. C-clips. Washers. Which go above. Like that. Okay. Then that. And the C. So let's do some real quick wipe down and add some more grease. I think this one I'm going to give a little bit of a clean. This one, the grease looks real, I don't know, greasy. But this stuff looks a little bit caked. So I'm going to give that a spray down with some brake parts cleaner and then go from there. I'll be back. The trick is to make sure that this doesn't fold over on itself. Or if it does, you fold it back.
See, folds over on itself. And then you gotta somehow get it to go back. It's kind of a pain. Don't use this. You dropped something. My favorite tool is this week. Yep, favorite tool. Hook it underneath, pull, making sure that doesn't go through that. That's my best suggestion. All right. Washer. Axle grease. think that's ready to go back in. As I was saying, put the washer on. All right, so what I need to do now is clean out the grease from there, and then I can basically reinstall the entire axle. I've already gone to the local hardware store and gotten replacement bolts for those four that I had to cut off. Four of 24, I'm gonna call that not too bad. And also for the age of the vehicle and the amount of neglect, not surprising, so. Pretty clean. For this one, I am using Lucas extra heavy duty grease, farm equipment, that kind of thing. Certainly won't hurt to have extra serious stuff. Off to do the other side. And obviously we don't want to forget where it meets the transmission. FYI, in case yours is as crusted up as mine was, I was using a 6mm hex bit, basically like an Allen key, to get it off. It needs an M8 12 point. So these are 12 point bolts to hold the axles on. And obviously the four replacement ones are gonna work off of this, not this. But I'm okay with that, because I imagine the 12-point one's going to be a wee bit expensive and a little bit hard to find. So I'm okay with this, but that would explain some of the issues I had. They were so crudded up, I just couldn't even see in there enough. Not to mention, you guys seen me, I wear glasses, I'm a little blind sometimes, and it just wasn't going to happen. So now that I know, I can install them correctly, get them torqued correctly, all should be good. Loctite on every one. Start with the upper one. Get them in. Proceed from there. I may get in your way. Thank you.
Alright, both sides are complete, installed. You can see a little bit of the grease squeeze out there. The other one. Bit of a pain in the butt every now and again. A couple of the CV joints themselves came apart, ball bearings popped out, had to rebuild them. I wasn't going to show that. It was a bit hard to film when you got nitrile gloves absolutely covered in grease and you're swearing occasionally. So it was not a a video moment, shall we say. So at any rate, one axle, two axles, another project done. With the engine out, life's a little bit easier that way. It's nice to be able to just sort of sit in a stool and have at it. So next up, I think, is going to be, I'll maybe address that bearing. That's probably not necessarily in the next episode, but next few. And I do have to finish priming the entire bug, cleaning out the inside, all that jazz. So plenty left to do. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you like it. Please leave a comment, give me a thumbs up, and subscribe if you're interested. I'll be putting up one episode a week.